In this video, I am going to explain the structure of hip joint and ligament of hip joint. First thing first, I will talk about structure of hip joint. The hip joint is very famous ball and socket joint. Head of femur is ball, you know, kind of ball structure. And on the pelvis, you see this socket part? This part is called acetabulum. This is very deep concave surface of pelvis. So again, head of femur and acetabulum of pelvis. So hip joint can do many movements like extension, flexion, and internal rotation, external rotation, abduction, open up leg, and close leg. This is adduction. So because of this ball and socket joint, hip joint can do so many movements. There's another very famous ball and socket joint in human body. Now I am showing you the shoulder joint. Shoulder joint is also very famous ball and socket joint. Head of humerus and glenoid fossa of scapula. Also, shoulder joint can do so many movements like flexion, extension, internal rotation, external rotation, and such a movement. What is different in between shoulder joint and hip joint? This is glenoid fossa and acetabulum. This depth is very different, right? Acetabulum is very deep. And glenoid fossa is not very deep. Because of this difference of the depth, shoulder joint can do so much movement. This is very movable joint. But shoulder joint doesn't have much stability because of the bony structure. On the other hand, acetabulum is very deep. Head of femur is very big. That's why hip joint doesn't have much mobility like shoulder joint. Instead, hip joint has so much stability. Of course, hip joint moves a lot if you compare with sacroiliac joint. Hip joint moves a lot. But if you compare with shoulder joint, hip joint doesn't have much mobility, but it has a lot of stability. So I said hip joint has a lot of stability. If I have to talk about stability, I have to talk about ligaments. So I will talk about ligaments of hip joint. Basically, there are three ligaments on hip joint. The very front one. This beige tape represents a ligament. So what is this ligament? It looks like it attaches on pubis and femur. So this ligament is pubofemoral ligament. It connects pubis and femur. Pubofemoral ligament. If you go to the side, you see other ligament. So this one connects ilium and femur. So this ligament is iliofemoral ligament. Iliofemoral ligament. Now I am looking at the pelvis and hip joint from backside. We have one more ligament. This ligament looks like it connects ischium and femur. So this ligament is ischiofemoral ligament. We have three ligaments. Ischiofemoral ligament, iliofemoral ligament, and pubofemoral ligament. These ligaments are very strong ligaments. And we see one more beige tape here. What is this? This is not a hip joint ligament, but this is very important for hip joint. This is obturator membrane. Obturator membrane. It doesn't look like this obturator membrane has relationship with hip joint because this is a little bit far away from hip joint. But obturator membrane has connective tissue connection with pubofemoral ligament. If obturator membrane gets tight, it can create tension on cubofemoral ligament. Or if cubofemoral ligament gets tension, it can bring attention to obturator membrane. One more thing, obturator membrane has muscle attachments, which is obturator externus from outside and obturator internus from inside of the pelvis. So if either one of muscle gets tight, it can create tension on obturator membrane and it can create tension around pubofemoral ligament, then it can create tension around hip joint. So these connective tissue connections are very important for joint stability. In this video, I talked about basic structure of hip joint and I compared structure with shoulder joint. In second part, I explained the ligaments of hip joint and relationship with obturator membrane. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy structure. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.